All right. So, I am tired. I slept for an hour, and then I woke back up for whatever reason, and now I have a little bit of energy. So what I am going to do is make a smoothie. So I've never really made a smoothie before, and we'll see how it turns out. All right, so the first step in making a smoothie is unboxing the thing that blends the smoothie, which is this Nutribullet. Shout out to Ben and Ashley Consul for getting me this for Christmas 2 years ago. So it's finally being put to good use. So also right now, my phone is in a very precarious state. So I'm just hoping it doesn't fall. Okay, so I'm gonna unbox this box and we will see how this goes. First, I need a knife. Yeah, I found the knife. I also think you can't probably return this now, just because of how long it's been. Let's see here. Oh, it says, "Welcome to Team Nutribullet. We are excited to have you in the mix. Time to unbox the benefits of better nutrition. Namaste." Okay. So you have information packets, which contain information. It's also a user guide, but we don't need the user guide yet. And then, oh, ways to build a smoothie. Very helpful, I believe. I'm gonna keep that aside because I think I might need that. This one is in French. We don't need that, but we still respect those French people that are or not watching this spectacle. It also looks like I have like things on my shirt. There's a warranty and registry card. It's 1 year limited warranty from the date of purchase, and I can register it online for 3 additional months of warranty. So that's a great thing. So I'm gonna keep that aside. I'm gonna open this up. So also, living in an apartment in mid downtown-ish. It's a very small kitchen. I can twirl around and that's the extent of the kitchen. So that's why you can't really see a lot. And if you see a lot, I think my mom would be upset because she doesn't like people seeing when things are a mess. So what she doesn't know probably won't hurt her because I don't think she knows what I'm doing. Cup. A bigger Nutra cup. The Nutribullet with a Nutra cup on it already. Exciting times. What fell? The Nutribullet cut thingy, the slice and dice, also is there. Clearly some of this garbage. Okay, and we have a lid.
I'm assuming I have definitely assumed wrong. I thought the lids would go on here, but maybe they do. Yes, they do. You just have to unscrew the other part. Okay, so I'll make my little smoothie tonight in this little cup. I got two of those little lid guys. I wonder if I should wash this out before I use it. I don't know. I guess I should. COVID is probably not a good thing, and it's always good to be clean. So I'm gonna wash this out over here in the kitchen. So only add liquid to whatever max line it is after we had put in all of our ingredients. So let's get to the ingredients today, shall we? Ah, yes. Beautiful. We have Canadian blueberries just in season. So, I'm gonna put some blueberries in the little cup thing. Yeah. They're frozen, by the way. Gonna put it up here so you guys can see too. They also put lettuce. They put leafy greens. Leafy greens. I think I have some leafy greens. Oh, look! I'm in luck! Leafy greens! It's kale. Alright, so I'm gonna put some leafy greens in it. Right at the bottom thingy. This could either be really delicious or disgustingly gross. It's sad that those are the only two options in life sometimes. Okay, so then we add our little berry guys. Because it's the same color as the berries. Okay. The berries are done. And for our last ingredient, we have Greek yogurt, which is high in protein. I might have overfilled this cup. I'm not sure what could go wrong. Greek yogurt. I'll put it on here. You can see. I'm gonna stir up the Greek yogurt. Because it's mighty chunky. I hope it's still good. Put some Greek yogurt inside. Gonna put some more Greek yogurt inside. And it looks finished for now. Gonna put the spoon
And the next step is to basically put back all your ingredients. And then I will put I am an idiot. So this was the one that I washed. And this was the one that wasn't washed. I don't think that's how this goes. Okay, still trying to figure this out. Okay, so it is in the cup and ready to blend. So you just push down on it to blend it. Okay. I'm gonna pack away some stuff, so there is some room. I also realized I need to plug this in. I'm gonna bring this up here so you can see it in all its glory, and I don't know if this is wise or not, but I'm gonna put it on a stand. That's a little too high. On the stand. It's kind of a weird stand, but we're gonna see how this works. So I have to unplug the microwave just because that's the closest outlet. Okay, so the microwave is unplugged, the Nutribullet is plugged in, and we shall try to make this kale, berry, and Greek yogurt smoothie. Overfill it because it's not. This is a French one. Oh, okay. So apparently it requires the use of liquids. So I'm gonna have to put some liquid in here. And I just know the perfect thing. So normally we're not a household that has a lot of juice in it. I'm not sure why. But we do have kombucha. And I actually seriously wonder how this will go with this. Okay. Kombucha. One thing I was thinking about as I was doing this is that the kombucha is fizzy. So I don't know if that's gonna like cause pressure and stuff, but yeah. Gonna let that soak up in there. Bubbles out. And okay, and in case you're wondering, the kombucha is raspberry lemonade. Perfect. Actually, this might be good for this. Actually, that's tasting good already. Okay, I'm actually getting a little excited for this.
was on tight. Definitely looks a lot grosser now. Oh, fudge. So I don't know how long, but it seems like this is good. And it looks like a smoothie. Okay, so I'm going to unplug this. I'm going to move this out of the way. And I'm going to get a cup for it. I don't know why I checked that cabinet, because that's not where we keep our cups. So I'm not sure why I did that, but hey, when you're alive, right? The other thing is, we're not even gonna taste test this. We're gonna give this to my mother, who's gonna make a very special appearance in this thing, and see how she likes it. Yeah. It's really tight. That's what she said. Oh no, she wouldn't say that. She might say that. Oh wow, okay. So honestly, this actually looks really good. Looks like a big goop of goop. Alright, save some for myself. Save some for myself, and this is for my mother. So let's see what my mom thinks about this. She's probably really angry that I record her. Made a smoothie. Try it.
Like, can I drink now?
Try it.
I brushed my... No, you're not taking a photo.
No, I'm not. I just need you to try it, please. Mom, I spent a long time. Take a sip.
That looks good, though.
But take a sip, please.
Don't take a photograph.
No, it's not a photograph. This is so pathetic.
What's in there?
Why are you yelling?
No, don't do that.
Okay, so what's...
Ryan.
Wait, so what's inside there? Is that what you're asking? So I put kale, I put blueberries, I put the Greek yogurt, and then we didn't have juice. You're supposed to put juice in it. So I had a can of kombucha, so I put the kombucha.
But do you have to put juice?
You do. You need liquid in it.
Oh my gosh, that's
here,
good.
Try it again.
No, I don't. I just brush my teeth.
You already drank some, so it doesn't make a difference.
No, I can't take it now. It's too soft. Wow. If you make that every morning, the car to work, or carry the blender to work and make it
a... I'm not carrying a blender to work. Anyways, thank you.
You like the blender?
I do like the blender.
Oh my gosh, that's good. And you could make it and leave it how long in the fridge?
That is really good. That is really good.
It is really good. And you could put... No, you shouldn't put chocolate in it. Mm. That is good. But you know what? Spinach and kale is good base. Ryan, don't post that anywhere, please.
Of course not.